Welcome to Anole Alley. In this episode, you're going to meet my pet Anole, Spirit. Some of you already know Spirit. And for those of you who don't, check out his video, Free Spirit. It will explain how he came to live inside my home as a pet. Now, I don't recommend taking animals from the wild for pets. There are many already in pet stores looking for homes. Besides, captive wild animals generally do not do well. Spirit's case was a bit unusual. When I acquired him back in July of 2007, he was a small hatchling. Today, it's early February 2008. He's 7 months old. He's done nicely in this 30-gallon tank with a full-spectrum UV light, living on a diet of flies. He's growing quickly and beginning to mature. Lately, I've seen him staring out the window, giving territorial displays to someone outside. Someone I can't see. He's reaching breeding age, and his hormones are telling him he must find a mate. I found it rather sad to watch as he diligently displayed his readiness to find a mate, but all in an effort in futility. Unless I could catch him a wild mate. After putting a few females in the tank with him, he was so aggressive, I had to take them and release them. As time went on, I could see clearly the time had come. Time to free Spirit again and release him back into the wild. The next day was warm and sunny, a beautiful day for a release. Soon, Spirit would again run free. Over here in this wood pile, he'll have plenty of cover and have time to get acquainted with his new surroundings. Done. Freedom at last. I tried to follow him, but he quickly vanished into the brush. Could this be the last time that I would ever see him? If so, I believe I did the best thing for him. Weeks passed by, then while out filming, near the brush pile, a rustle in the leaves, and down at my feet, an Anole. It looks like Spirit. A little older and more filled out, but the markings down his neck and back match. If indeed this is Spirit, he's done quite well. Then, I try a little experiment. Will he come to me? Well, so much for that. Of course, Spirit never really liked me much anyway. Maybe he just approached me to say hello and thank you for setting me free. From the looks of it, he's getting plenty to eat out here. Eventually, Spirit set up permanent housekeeping near the fence, over by the dog kennels, just like all the others. Of course, I can't be 100% sure that this Anole is Spirit without DNA testing. Sorry guys, that's just not in Stardust budget. But I'd like to think this is Spirit. Right now, he finds himself with some company. Another Anole has been calling this old stump home and doesn't wish to go quietly. But Spirit is much bigger, and he insists. I'm not quite sure, but this Anole looks like a small male. Well, just how will Spirit fare back in the wild? Check out part 2 and find out.